Along the western coast of the Hudson River, there are a series of scenic, dark-colored cliffs. These several hundred-foot-tall cliffs are exposed along a lengthy stretch of both New Jersey and New York. While they might not look like much, they represent the remains of a different period of the planet's geologic history when volcanoes dotted the landscape and fresh lava flows covered the region. These cliffs are known as the Palisades and formed from ancient magmatic activity related to numerous large-scale volcanic eruptions, the likes of which have not been seen in modern times. These eruptions caused one of the planet's largest mass extinction events, and thus the thick cliffs are related to that event, which saw the extinction of numerous species such as the phytosaur Mysteriosa chush planirostris. The Palisades and their associated magmatic rock cover a wide swath of the tri-state area. Its rock exposure is 45 miles long, 1.3 miles wide, and averages more than 1,000 feet thick. This feature is almost completely composed of a rock type known as diabase. Diabase is an intrusive volcanic rock that forms when intrusions of magma solidify beneath the surface. Thus, because of this rock, we know that the rock unit originated deep underground, which in this case was determined to be a depth of 2 to 3 miles. This makes the exposure a combination of a massive sill and group of magmatic dikes which once prominently moved many thousands of cubic kilometers of molten rock to more distant locations, eventually erupting onto the surface. All of this occurred in a brief time span between the end of the Triassic and beginning of the Jurassic periods. 200 million years ago, much of the Earth looked like a completely different planet. The climate was 5 degrees Celsius or 8 degrees Fahrenheit warmer than it is today, and large swaths of the planet were covered in rainforests. Numerous early dinosaurs existed, but they were relatively small, such as the species known as Colophysis, which was 2 meters long and 1 meter tall. In other words, dinosaurs of this era were at most the size of a modern crocodile monitor. In these rainforests, the first flowering plants had yet to form, so they were far less colorful than their modern counterparts. Also, sections of South America, North America, and Africa were joined together as part of one massive supercontinent called Pangaea. Although this continent had existed for 100 million years, it was at the end of its lifespan. The mushroom-shaped head of an underlying hotspot in the mantle had finally reached the crust, causing large volumes of magma to pour onto the surface. This hotspot caused the continents to slowly break apart, triggering even more volcanic eruptions. These eruptions were largely effusive, similar to those witnessed in Hawaii today. However, individual so-called flood basalt events covered tens of thousands of square kilometers in lava. Numerous flood basalt eruptions occurred at the same time in sections of modern Morocco, Brazil, and eastern North America. However, the path molten rock took to the surface was not necessarily a straight line upwards. Rather, it zigzagged through the crust, forming large horizontal sills of material which occurred through a single rock unit, and dikes which cut through several rock units. The Palisades represented one of these magmatic conduits, transferring large volumes of magma closer to the surface. This magma would go on to erupt a several hundred foot thick layer of black volcanic rock between the modern cities of Bound Brook and Ramsey in New Jersey. One prominent exposure of this flood basalt can today be found to the north of Montclair State University, where the cliffs to the east represent the edge of the ancient flows of lava. Eventually, the magmatic conduit stopped transporting new material, and the basaltic composition magma solidified as a rock type, diabase. These widespread flood basalts ejected large volumes of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, causing much of the oceans to turn acidic and raising the average temperature. This caused the subsequent mass extinction, which in a mere 10,000 years caused 30% of all marine species to go extinct. In the 200 million years since, much of the rock overlying this hill has eroded away, and in addition to a 15-degree tilt has allowed a large segment of ancient volcanic rock to become visible on the surface. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Adam Gatewood for supporting this channel.